I just wonder if you could tell me what the situation was, certainly how it's sort of stabilised, and what's being done.
Yeah.
So three questions for the price of one there.
Okay,
where we're going with the money, as it were.
Okay, no, absolutely. So I suppose the first thing I would say is that, you know, it's not really for me to kind of either blame or cast aspersions around what happened in the past. What I do know is that the finances have been very challenging for the last 14 months, and they led to a position where we had a gentleman, very nice gentleman, called the Further Education Commissioner, David Collins, come into the college and look at our finances. So that was back in February, and he produced a report on what he saw as the four, the kind of key financial challenges. And I've spent a lot of time in the last few months, and my predecessor before me, trying to address those challenges. So the position now is that all the recommendations in the FE Commissioner's report have been met, and I see the position moving out of recovery and into stability. So what do I mean by that?
Yeah, I was going to say, what sort of things had to be done to get the college from, I mean, I know it's not the only public body that's facing these challenges, but it was a particularly difficult time. What needs to be done to get it back to this stable footing?
Well, I think there's probably two things. It's probably worth reflecting on some things that were problematic within the college. I think we should be very open and clear about that. There's no point pretending. But some things are also relating to the if you like, the state of finances nationally. So we lost about 40% of our budget for adults over the course of the last parliament, and around 15% of our budget for 16 to 18 year olds. Now, I would suggest that any business would find it very challenging to cope with that level of cuts. But there were also things in the way that City College operated that I've been seeking to address, which allow us to manage the finances a bit better. So the position for our last published accounts was that our underlying deficit was about 1.8 million. This year, I fully anticipate that we will produce a small surplus. It'll be about £200,000 or 1% of our income. And the way we've done that is through addressing the things that the FE Commissioner asked us to. So we've got a proper hold of our budgeting process. And so now I'm very confident that the kind of assumptions that underpin the budget are sound. So I'm confident that the things that we think we're going to spend, we are actually going to spend. And so far in the year, that appears to be the case.